AWA Championship Wrestling. The AWA presents the greatest stars in professional wrestling, bringing you the best in mat action. Welcome to AWA Championship Wrestling on ESPN, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Larry Nelson with AWA President Joe Blanchard. You promised us a decision on the heavyweight championship of the world. Please, sir, what is that decision?
Well, the decision has been made. We burned a lot of midnight, all the two referees and myself. We reviewed the tapes from every angle possible, and there was no doubt that Sergeant Slaughter hit Gary and knocked him out. And the disqualification stands, so Larry Zybysko is the world's champion.
The championship belt returns to Larry Zybysko entering the area, and once again, we have Larry Land in rule.
You know something? It never left Larry Land. I think it's about time the AWA had a president like Mr. Blanchard, who knows what justice is all about. It's just like I said in my interview previous to when Sergeant Slaughter tried to rip me off, that he should be disqualified, and I'm glad he was disqualified.
There's going to be a lot of disappointed fans out there. Let me
just say one more thing. You are not going to dictate to the president anymore about what match.
Okay,
about what match you take and who you take it with, and there will be a match between you and Sergeant Slaughter under terms that I say, not you say.
Well, what kind of terms? What are you talking about, terms?
I say, under terms.
Well, I mean,
they're going to be decided.
To my lawyer,
gentlemen, as of right now, we're out of time. There will be a match, ladies and gentlemen. We'll be back.
Ladies and gentlemen, the AWA is on tour throughout North America. And to that point of special interest to those of you planning a fundraiser, why not bring the AWA to your town? A tremendous fundraising idea. All you have to do is call the AWA Event Center. The number is 612-545-9376. Bring all the excitement of the AWA to your hometown fundraiser.
Before you buy brand-name sneakers, think about this. What good is spending a fortune on sneakers if you have nothing left over to play with?
In a world where the line between good and evil have been destroyed, a new breed of hero and a mysterious cyborg are on a mission that has sparked a battle. That will change the future of civilization. Jean-Claude Van Damme is the first hero of the 21st century in Cyborg. Available September 20th on video cassette.
At BIC, we've been studying all the ways that you pull and stretch your face in search of a better shave. Now BIC presents our solution, introducing the new BIC Metal Shaver. The patented BIC Metal stretches and smooths your skin thanks to its unique metal guard bar, so the shaver glides closely and comfortably. Now, instead of stretching, start reaching for a new BIC Metal Shaver. It stretches your skin for a better shave, and that's no stretch.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. I am waiting to interview a man who is certainly the most disappointed man in all of professional wrestling, maybe the most disappointed man in the world, period, and that is, of course, Sergeant Slaughter, who I honestly believed was the heavyweight champion of the world. And, Sarge, all I can say is I share in your disappointment.
Well, I went out with one reason in mind, that was to win the title from Larry Zybysko. I felt that I won the title. I hit the referee, but it wasn't on purpose.
I know it.
I got Larry Zybysko in the Cobra Clutch, and the next thing I know, the bell rang, and I was the winner. I was the world champion. I've had a lot of disappointments in my life. I've had a lot of letdowns in my life. But I have to go with what the president says. He's the general. I'm only a sergeant. He said that he reviewed the tapes, and I don't like the decision, but I have to stand with it because he is the president. But he has told me that I will get a rematch. And Larry Zybysko, you know that any time, any day, I can beat you. Everybody knows now that if I can put the Cobra Clutch on you, you're done. You're history. You won't be the champion again. I put up with the death of my own mother. I saw her die of cancer. I put up with a lot of things in my life. This is very disappointing to me. I worked hard all my life, ever since I was a Boy Scout, ever since I was in the Marines. I fought battles in Vietnam. I was ambushed over there. Hardly got back on my own two feet. But I'm going to do it again, Larry Zybysko. I'm not the one that got beat. You got beat. And you're going to get beat again because Sergeant Slaughter can beat you. You know it. All the fans know it. And most of all, Mr. Blanchard knows it.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be back right after this.
Want to have some fun right now without leaving your home? Just pick up the phone and dial the Romance Connection. Call anytime, 24 hours, and listen to recorded messages from fun-loving singles. They tell about themselves and leave their numbers so you can call them right away. Right away, call now.
Call anytime, 24 hours. The Romance Connection, 1-900-909-8080. $2 first minute, 45 cents additional minutes.
Put some romance in your life.
A few words on business and change.
The journals are daily, and that gives you a real competitive advantage. It's very tough out there, but it's also very exciting. We want to be the best ally that you've got.
Today's Wall Street Journal. Faster, tougher, smarter. Call 800-372-3000 for this special journal offer. 12 weeks, just $29.75 with a money-back guarantee. Call 800-372-3000 now for the Wall Street Journal.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first in the ring, at a combined weight of 463 pounds, they hail out of Tokyo, Japan. They are the Tokyo Bullets.
Oh, I got a live one here.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents tonight weighed in a combined weight of 475 pounds. First, from San Diego, California, he is Tommy Jammer. And his tag team partner hails from Boston, Massachusetts. He is Derrick Starfire. Now on to Joe Blanchard and Lee Marshall.
Thank you very much, Dale. Lee Marshall along with Joe Blanchard, the brand new president of the AWA. And Joe, what we've got is a team that's really on the rise. Derrick Dukes and Tommy Jammer in there at the team we haven't seen before, the Tokyo Bullets. And they're serving notice right away how they intend to play this thing. And that is not by the book. Look at this. Double drop. Oh, look at this. Double atomic drop, and down go the Tokyo Bullets. Jammer and Dukes cleaning house, getting those Batman t-shirts off. Well, they don't look like Batman and Robin. Maybe we call them Black Man and Jammer.
After all these years, I'm still a fan. Oh. I enjoy tag matches.
I'm telling you, there's nothing like watching the guys who do it well. And you're looking at a couple of guys. I'm talking about Derrick Starfire Dukes and Tommy Jammer. They're making a name for themselves. And I'm not discounting the Tokyo Bullets. Quite honestly, Joe, this is my first opportunity to see them.
Mine also, and hear of them. But I tell you, they move around pretty good. They aren't real big men, or not as big as Dukes and Jammer.
Nope. Had a look at the big Tommy Jammer, the heartthrob out of San Diego, California, Surf City. Oh. I don't know if you can see the abrasion that's on Derrick Duke's arm. He got that in a recent battle with none other than the South African mercenary, Colonel De Beers. Double shot into the midsection, and down goes one of the Tokyo Bullets. Look at that. Oh! This could be all. One, two. Ooh, kick out. That's a great move by Derrick Duke's and Tommy Jammer. I love it. Look at the strength on this young man, Joe. Yeah. Uh-oh. Well, he is a young man. He does still make rookie mistakes.
There's well, Derrick. I tell you, that's not just a rookie mistake. A lot of veterans make it. The thing you have to do is be tough enough to come back from those mistakes and still, that's what makes it a match.
That's true. That's true. Jammer tagging off to Derrick Starfire Dukes. Ooh. Dick right into the arm, grabs it into the standing arm ringer, and here's a tag. I love the quick tags by Dukes and Jammer. Working right on that left arm again into a standing arm ringer. Again, he rings it around, and Dukes punctuates it, kicking one of the Tokyo Bullets right in that already injured arm. Reversal by the Bullets. Well, he took Dukes a little bit by surprise. Reversal by Dukes. Oh, nice takedown. Got him hooked up. Count of two. Kick out by the Bullet. Derrick Dukes tagging off to San Diego's Tommy Jammer. Into the ropes goes the Bullet. Double backdrop. Boy, they sent him first-class mail across the ring.
Almost out of it.
Yeah. Into the ropes again. Elbow and down goes one of the Tokyo Bullets. At this point, ooh, guillotine leg drop by the Jammer. Got him hooked up. One, two. Uh-oh. One of the Tokyo Bullets coming in. At this point, I don't know which one is Bullet number one and which one is Bullet number two. Oh.
Ooh,
oh.
I hate to see that. I really hate to see that. I'm going to talk about that. We're going to.
Gary DeRusha warning him. Well, Jammer can sing the national anthem after a show.
Yeah.
Like oh.
He was up there that time.
Man, was he ever. Jammer's down. Two, three. Wow! What a power!
He was up there that time, too.
What strength. I mean, he just crush slammed him. Jammer was absolutely horizontal in the middle of the ring, and he pressed this kid right off of him. Whoa! And Jammer's back in the ring. I'll tell you, Tommy Jammer.
He reversed that move down here on the floor and did a power slam with it instead of taking the punishment that the Bullet was intending.
Yeah, now there's a different guy in the ring, Joe. I don't know if you saw it, but the man that Tommy Jammer slammed is not the man in the ring. Again, we're still trying to determine who's number one and who's number two, but you can see that Bullet writhing in pain. He is actually the legal man in the ring. I mean, I'm not trying to do Gary DeRusha's job, Joe, but that's not the right man in the ring. Standing arm ringer into a hammerlock by Derrick Starfire Dukes. Ooh, elbow. And Dukes again applying the pressure on the standing hammer. And another elbow, and Dukes forced to totally release the hold. Now you got both Tokyo Bullets in the ring. Into the ropes goes Dukes, and down goes Dukes. Jammer trying to get involved, and Gary DeRusha's run him out of the ring. We got 5 minutes gone in this match. Tommy Jammer holding on to the tag rope. Whoa, what a drop kick.
That little guy's a flyer, that little Bullet.
Gee, did he get up? He got all the way to the top floor on Derrick Dukes. An elbow that misses. Dukes rolls out of the way.
Just missed. Just barely got out of the way.
Good opportunity for Derrick Dukes now. Ooh!
Great move.
I think he's got him, Joe, too. Gary DeRusha's got his hands full. One of the Bullets grabbing Dukes by the trunks and throwing him out. Referee's distracted, and one of the Bullets has got Dukes outside of the ring, and here comes Tommy Jammer. He's had enough. He wants into this. DeRusha trying to restore some sort of order. Looks like they're going to try to bring him in the hard way. Blocked by Dukes. Another block by Dukes. Right hands into the midsection by Derrick Dukes. And Dukes has got him. He's going for the sunset flip. He got him over. One, two. Oh, almost a three count.
And once again, Gary DeRuscia having to run Tommy Jammer out of the ring. Oh! Right hand by Derek Starfire Duke. Going for the noggin knocker. He got it. The triple noggin knocker by Derek Dukes. Right hand by Dukes. Another right hand, and down goes the bullet. He picks him up again. He says, Jammer, get that boot up here, brother. Boom! He nailed it. Here's the tag, and here comes Tommy Jammer. Into the ropes. Jammer's got him.
They thwarted each other's moves, and they countered. Both of them countered.
He got it vertical. Jammer with a vertical suplex. One, two. Foot on the rope. I thought Jammer had him on that one, Joe. Game of the ropes. Standing bear hug. Oh, he dropped him. He dropped him from that bear hug position. They make the tag, and here comes Derek Starfire Dukes along with Tommy Jammer. Double elbow. Jammer, the legal man, into the ring. And he tags off to Derek Dukes. DeRuscia putting the count out. One of these guys has got to get out of the ring pretty quickly. Double clothesline on one of the Tokyo Bullets. And it's Jammer that leaves the ring. Derek Dukes, the legal man, in. Crowd always wants that mask removed. Rake of the eyes by one of the Tokyo Bullets. Standing drop kick. Wow.
Good move.
You bet.
8 minutes. Time in this match.
8 minutes gone in this match. One of the Bullets into the ropes. Into the midsection. Sunset split by Jammer. One, two, three. It's over. It's all over. They do keep getting better and better, Joe. Derek Dukes and Tommy Jammer.
That's a good tag team combination.
I enjoy watching them. Yes. Always enjoy watching them.
Seen the rest, now get the best.
It's TV's greatest sports bloopers.
60 minutes of the wildest, wackiest, funniest super bloopers ever recorded on one video cassette.
From football fumbles to basketball fumbles, it's the sports blooper video everyone's been waiting for.
Whether it's on the green or over the net or into the drink, you'll enjoy plenty of non-stop gut-busting, bone-jarring blooper action.
From the majors to the minors and around the world, you'll be amazed at the outrageous antics of some of your favorite sports and Hollywood movie stars.
Get ready for hit after hit of the most bizarre bloopers and sports foul-ups you'd ever expect to see.
Use your credit card now and get a pair of sports sunglasses free.
This offer not available in stores.
So for 60 minutes of the funniest collection of breathtaking, rip-tickling sports bloopers ever,
use your credit card and order TV's greatest sports bloopers today.
Today.
Call now 1-800-554-8000 for TV's greatest sports bloopers for $19.95 plus shipping and handling. Use your credit card now and get a pair of sunblocker sports sunglasses free. Call now 1-800-554-8000 to get both a blooper video and free sunglasses. It's hilarious.
That was me, Tommy Lasorda, the way I used to look until I tried Ultra Slim Fast and I lost 30 pounds. With Ultra Slim Fast, I can eat and still lose weight.
Ultra Slim Fast, give us a week, we'll take off the weight.
I use pressure-treated lumber and still have expensive water damage. Why?
Even treated wood needs Thompson's Water Seal. It penetrates to protect wood, brick, and concrete from water damage. Thompson's, the first name in lasting protection.
Hi, everybody. Welcome back to Championship Wrestling right here on ESPN. A tremendous main event coming up for you. WWA Heavyweight Champion Mike George is going to challenge Greg Gagne for the AWA International Television Championship. That's coming right up. Now, I want to address some people who seem to be hanging their heads over a problem we feel that we've got in society. They say, we have no heroes. Well, I want to put that to rest and kind of recall some things that I've seen as a broadcaster. I was behind the microphone and saw Kirk Gibson hit a home run for the Los Angeles Dodgers in the World Series last year, but that was not the most dramatic thing I ever saw. He was also behind the microphone in 1984 in my hometown of Los Angeles, California. During the Olympics, I got to see a true American hero. For the first time in America's history, a heavyweight Greco-Roman wrestler won the gold medal in the Olympics. You talk about a hero, I want to introduce him to you right now. America's hero, if you will, to be sure, Jeff Blatnick. How you doing, Jeff?
I'm doing fine. Good to be here.
What's going on now with Jeff Blatnick?
Well, I'm in the motivating business. I try to give people what's considered a positive attitude. I want to unlock the human spirit inside of all of us, which sometimes can limit what we feel we're capable of doing. And all I try to do is help people who've had the same problems as myself with the American Cancer Society and Leukemia Society, but I've taken it further. I've taken it to corporate America now, and I try to motivate employees of these corporations to try and fulfill their potential. And if you can do that, the corporation as a whole will grow as well as the individual.
Well, that's an interesting point. Not only are you a champion as an athlete, a champion as a man to overcome your bout against cancer, and I want you to help some people overcome something, because I personally am tired of people saying, well, America's not what she used to be. We used to like to say we are number one, but there are some people out there that don't think we're number one, and I'm talking to you corporations. I think it's important you give this man a call. How do people get in touch with you, Jeff?
Well, I could be reached through my office in New York City. That's Athletes and Artists at 212-695-0300, or you can get me in my hometown of Albany, New York, and that number is 518-463-5244.
Perhaps the greatest athlete, amateur wrestler we've ever produced, Jeff Blatnick, and the greatest professional wrestler of all time is here to offer his congratulatory words. Vern Gagne.
Well, I certainly am, and anyone that can win a gold medal at the Olympics and be ready at that precise moment when you have to be ready to accomplish it, I got to take my hat off to you. And, Jeff, you did it, and it was the first time that, as you said earlier, that a heavyweight champion, we had a heavyweight champion in Greco-Roman wrestling. And I know, Jeff, you're helping to coach now the American team and helping those boys get in shape to go over to Europe. And why don't you tell us a little bit about that and who's on it?
Well, we're training right now. We're trying to get prepared for the World Championships in the tail end of August in Switzerland. And we have a couple of the Olympians from the 1988 team representing the U.S., and that's Michael Foy, John Morgan, and Andy Saris. And I think with their experience helping out the rest of the guys, the United States will continue to make progress in the Greco-Roman style, hopefully brings home some more medals.
And, Jeff, you're a great inspiration for me. You're working out the heavyweights, I know, and still beating them. So perhaps maybe you should step in there and help us out a little bit.
Well, I'm not quite sure if I'm ready for competition at this point, but I feel good. I'm healthier than I've ever been in the last 3-4 years. I keep feeling better every year. And if I can look this good when I'm getting a little bit older, when I mature as a wrestler, then I'll be very proud. Vern, you've been a great champion.
Thank you very much, and it's a pleasure to have you on our program. I know you do some work with ESPN, and we're delighted to have you and work with you.
Thank you.
Two of the greatest champions of all time, ladies and gentlemen. We will be right back. Don't go away. Right after this.
Dickies takes you back through the ages to show you if you're the famous people who've worn Dickies pants. Your dad. General George Armstrong Custer, Abraham Lincoln, Blackbeard the Pirate, William Shakespeare, Robin Hood, Attila the Hun. You too can wear these famous pants by Dickies, available every day at famous low prices. Dickies, famous since 1922. Attila the Hun, made with Fortran polyester by Fiber Industries.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is one fall with a 10-minute time limit. Introducing first in the ring at 243 pounds from Harlem, New York, he is Ray Brown. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, now making his way to the ringside area at 360 pounds, he is the world super heavyweight arm wrestling champion from Minneapolis, Minnesota. Here he is. Shout out to Zybysko and Joe Fleischer.
I'll tell you what, Joe, every time Scott Flash Norton has a match, the crowd just seems to react to him more and more. I think they're beginning to recognize just how much potential this young giant has.
Yeah, he's a superman as far as his strength is concerned, and his... He's showing his agility, and as he develops skills, he certainly will be. I think he's doing it now just because he's unbeatable.
Not
because of his skills, not because he can beat the opponent. He just is unbeatable himself.
DeRouche asks for the clean break, and Norton gives it to him. And look at him just muscle Ray Brown. Brown's no lightweight. I mean, 243 pounds. Whoa! But Norton outweighs him by 120 pounds. I mean, it's tough to be 243 pounds and have somebody call you tiny. But that's the way it is. Scott Flash Norton is just a big, big man, a giant of a man. Ray Brown now using the equalizer, the top rope, raking Flash Norton's eyes across the rope. Arusha calling for a break. So far, Brown is all over Norton, figuring that the only way he has a chance is perhaps taking his eyesight away from him. Whip across the rope. Oh, gosh, what a shoulder tackle by Scott Norton. Into the ropes goes Brown.
Ooh, he clubbed him with that. That's like hitting a guy with a two before.
No kidding. No kidding. Referee Gary DeRusha says it was clean all the way. I mean, it sawed him down like a tree, but it was clean all the way. Backdrop by Norton. Ray Brown, he's already breathing through his mouth, Joe.
Yeah, he's
got him. He's got him breathing. Boy, as if didn't being thrown into the turnbuckle doesn't take it out of you. Then you get slammed by 363 pounds of Scott Flash Norton.
No, there's no give over there either. Nope. That's what hurts double bad. Yeah, I tell you, that's a tough boy. He's fighting back.
He sure is, but his punches, and they're landing right into the ample midsection of Scott Flash Norton and having absolutely no effect on this young man. The super arm wrestling champion of the world. Elbow by Norton, and down goes Brown. Once again into the ropes. And there's that bear hug, Joe. The big squeeze.
I don't believe
that's
not.
It.
He's had it.
I've had it. Get me out of here.
That man's a powerhouse.
Zybysko seems to think that Norton isn't ready for him, and the truth is I tend to agree with the living legend at this point. I'll tell you, I can't imagine Larry Zybysko or any human being having that bear hug of Scott Norton wrapped around him, let alone Ray Brown. Look at this. He picks Brown up like he's just one of those Cabbage Patch dolls, puts the big squeeze on him, and that's it. Brown says, let me out of here. Let me out of here.
A man with that much strength is capable of beating anybody on a given day, though. He can catch them, and he could beat Larry Zybysko under a similar circumstance like that. Just catch him with that bear hug. It's over.
For the taste so crisp, so clean, so refreshing, it's the king of beers.
The dog ate it.
It's
my brother's holding it for ransom.
Aliens ransacked my room.
My printer's down.
You won't need excuses for losing your schoolwork with the Trapper Keeper, because Trapper's special folders and pockets keep an amazing amount of work organized, secure, and right where you want it.
It's on a spaceship to Pluto.
The one and only Trapper, only from Mead.
How far can you drive your car on Phillips 66 Drop Arctic?
100,000 miles.
Just by changing your oil every 3,000 miles?
Okay, more than 100,000 miles.
Oh, sure, Tri-Party can protect your engine in the heat and the cold, but over 100,000 miles?
How about 200,000 miles?
Come on, how far can you really drive on Tri-Party?
250,000 miles so far.
Phillips 66 Tri-Party. Long live your car.
Welcome back to AWA Championship Wrestling here on ESPN. And with me, again, Mr. Lee Marshall. And Lee, we have an exciting match coming up next, one that I've been waiting for, and I imagine you have as well.
Oh, I have. I know all the fans have. Two very talented young ladies. Morgan LaFay is challenging the new ladies sports club champion. That is Nina Moretti. And folks, when you see Nina in action, she is on a mission. She wants more than anything else, Eric, to get into the ring with five times ladies champion and current AWA champion of the world, Wendy Richter. So let's have a look at Nina Moretti and Morgan LaFay.
Let's go to the match.
Welcome back, fans, to the Odeum Expo Center here in Chicago, Illinois. In the ring now, from Las Vegas, Nevada, Morgan LaRoe, right here, from Las Vegas, baby. Her opponent this evening, from Bel Air, California, the Ladies Sports Club Champion, Tina!
No kidding. Tina Moretti, champion of the Ladies Sports Club, challenged
by Morgan LaRoe.
Morgan LaRoe from Las Vegas, Nevada.
Is that the city of gambling or sin? I don't know.
No!
Tina, like Magnificent Mimi, Wendy Richter, and many others, is a technician.
Yep.
Oh, a drop kick.
Nicely done by Tina Moretti. Look at this.
Woo,
ooh,
baby.
Nice takedown by Tina.
Tina looks gorgeous in that hot purple.
Doesn't she? Well, Tina would look gorgeous in a potato sack.
I guess so. Tina Moretti, who's been trained and introduced to professional wrestling by the AWA champion, none other than Wendy Richter, has control of this match.
And that would be a match to see if it could ever be made, David. A match between...
You know they're friends.
I know they're friends.
What's this, a whip? Or the belt taken off Morgan? Morgan's trying to whip Tina. Tina quickly seizes the wrist, grabs her. Morgan off Whoa. Balance, tripping. Throwing
oh,
into
head
top
first
turnbuckle.
Into the turnbuckle. And now Tina Moretti with a belt. And she snapmares Morgan LaRoe over with it. And Tina unrelenting, she's still got Morgan. Again, snapmare, courtesy of that black, thick leather belt.
You know, I'm going to be joining back in the dressing rooms a little bit later, Lee. Bambi and the Bombshell Blondes to find out the status of that wrist, if she can take part in that big
Two,
battle.
Three,
There's
it's
a
all
pin,
over.
It's all over.
That's it. Boy, she had her all locked up. Moretti, Ladies Sports Club Champion.
You've just seen great ladies action here on AWA Championship Wrestling on ESPN, the Total Sports Network. Now, coming up next week is the ladies' final for the Battle Royal. That's coming up next week. At this time, I have Mean Mike Enos of the Destruction Crew, and I have to say, this is the moment I've been waiting for, an opportunity to talk to Mean Mike Enos. Mean Mike Enos, the first question I have is, you and your partner claim to be the uncrowned heavyweight tag team champions of the world.
Well, we should be on...
Hold on a second, Mike. What's going on here? We're a team.
This was an opportunity for
We're
me to...
We're a team. I'll handle this one, Mike. The Destruction Crew is the uncrowned champions of the world. And it's not before long that we will be the champions of the world, because we're responsible for putting the most men out of wrestling than any team in the history of professional wrestling. This destruction crew has the size, the strength, the power, the quickness, the speed, the agility to compete with any team in the world today. As a matter of fact, that's the only thing that the destruction crew and ESPN has in common. They like to interview the greatest athletes in the world, and being the destruction crew is the premier athletic team of the 90s. They don't mind putting us on their program, and the destruction crew will prevail as the number one.
They claim to be the best team in tag team wrestling today. Still to come, we have our main event, the international TV champion, Greg Gagne, against Mike George.
Why did I join the NRA? My father gave me the heritage of the out-of-doors, and that's what he stood for. It was his heritage, and he handed it down to me, and I'm able to hand it down to my children. And my representation for my heritage and my children's heritage is the NRA.
Join the NRA. Call this number now. For just $25, you'll receive all of the NRA's great benefits, including 12 exciting issues of the American Hunter or American Rifleman magazine, $600 gun theft, and $10,000 accidental death and dismemberment insurance, your official membership card and window decal, plus NRA's gold-graded insignia shooter's cap. Call now and receive NRA's Sportsman's Premium Pack, loaded with valuable discounts from the world's leading manufacturers of hunting, shooting, and sporting equipment. Call this toll-free number now.
They are my representative. That's why I joined the NRA.
Welcome back to AWA Championship Wrestling here on ESPN. And Lee Marshall, I've been waiting for this. I have to tell you, I'm extremely disappointed that Sergeant Slaughter was not awarded the match with Larry Zybysko.
You're such a choir boy. You are such a choir. Let me ask you a question. What happened when Pete Rose bumped an umpire? What happened when Billy Martin kicked dirt all over an umpire?
There's a difference there.
There's not a difference.
Well, there is,
Derek,
a big difference.
You
there...
bump, you hit, you deliberately interfere with
deliberately
the referee
interfere.
Or the
that's
umpire
the, that's
or the referee. Well, that was the judgment call. The fact of the matter is, Sergeant Slaughter, you hit the referee, and like Billy Martin, and like Pete Rose, you pay the price. The price was you get to go around saying, I almost beat Larry Zybysko.
The operative word in your point of view is deliberate. That was not a deliberate attack on referee Gary Jarusha. No matter how you look at it, it wasn't deliberate.
All right, let's give people an opportunity to see it again.
Let's take a look.
He's trying to get the Sarge up. Sarge has got Zybysko. Beautiful backdrop executed by Sergeant Slaughter. But Zybysko, he's quick to his feet. And let's just say he's to his feet anyway. Right hand by Zybysko. Another right hand by the living legend. A third right hand. Another right hand. The Sarge is hot. Oh, my word. Zybysko and Slaughter, they're just chucking right hands and left hands at each other. Oh. And Zybysko is down.
And Slaughter ready to go.
Sergeant Slaughter picking him up for the body slam, the backbreaker. Now for the cover. One, two. Kick out at two. As we've said so many times, Joe.
He's just nice.
Professional wrestler, not only do you have to be able to dish it out, but you better be able to take it.
He's just fighting through the cobwebs right now, yeah.
Slaughter goes for the Slaughter cannon, and he hit Gary Jarusha. He took Jarusha out. And here comes Zybysko. Zabisco's all over Slaughter, and Gary Jarusha, he's the one who got hit with a Slaughter cannon. Slaughter into that. Zybysko, he's got him in the Cobra Clutch. He's got him. Sergeant Slot, nobody gets out of this. If Larry Zybysko gets out of this Cobra Clutch, he'll be the first man I've ever seen do it. Referee Tom Burton in the ring now. One. I think Zabisco's out. Zabisco's out.
It's over.
Sergeant Slaughter is the heavyweight champion of the world. It's all over. We have a new heavyweight champion of the world. There he is, ladies and gentlemen, Sergeant Slaughter. The brand new AWA heavyweight champion of the world.
Lee Marshall, I can't understand how you could possibly look at that tape and tell me that Sergeant Slaughter did not deserve to win that match.
He didn't deserve to win the match. He hit the referee. But the fact of the matter is, it doesn't matter what you think, it doesn't matter what I think, it doesn't matter what you think. All that matters is what referee Gary DeRuscia thought, flat on his back with his bell rung, and what AWA President Joe Blanchard thought. They thought that Sergeant Slaughter should have been disqualified, and that is what happened. Now, understand this. Sergeant Slaughter, I would never in a thousand years take anything away from you. You are truly a spectacular wrestler. You got caught in the switches. Next time, you'll know better. That's all.
Well, Larry Zybysko, as far as I'm concerned, you got by the skin of your teeth, and Sergeant Slaughter, you really did deserve to win that match. But Lee Marshall, why don't you tell the people what's coming up next?
Well, what we've got coming up next in our main event right here on ESPN, a spectacular match. WWA champion Mike George, the big guy out of St. Joseph's, Missouri, and he will be taking on the international television champion, Greg Gagne. It's going to be a heck of a match, and it's coming right up.
At BIC, we've been studying all the ways that you pull and stretch your face in search of a better shave. Now BIC presents our solution, introducing the new BIC Metal Shaver. The patented BIC Metal stretches and smooths your skin thanks to its unique metal guard bar, so the shaver glides closely and comfortably. Now, instead of stretching, start reaching for a new BIC Metal Shaver. It stretches your skin for a better shave, and that's no stretch.
The Chiefs' hard-hitting defense is always on the warpath. Iron Mike Ditka and Chicago are ready to bear down. Mike Patrick and Joe Theismann bring you Sunday Night NFL live on ESPN.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following is a one-fall, non-title event. Introducing first, currently in the ring, weighing in at 265 pounds from St. Joseph, Missouri, he is the WWA Heavyweight Champion, Mike George. Entering the arena at this time, weighing in at 219 pounds, Minnesota, he is the AWA International Television Champion, Greg Gagne. The referee for this event is Gary DeRuscia.
Hi, everybody. Lee Marshall along with AWA President Joe Blanchard. Joe, I am excited to see this match for a couple of reasons. First of all, you got two champions. The WWA champion, Mike George, a real veteran. In there with another veteran, Greg Gagne. He is the international television champion. So you've got champion against champion, although this is a non-title match. But I'm anxious to see the behavior of Greg Gagne. He's coming off a fine after what happened.
Yes, and Greg's track record is great. He's done well, and he's held his temper and kept it in the ring. But
ooh, good go behind by Gagne. Yeah, last time we saw Greg was with Sheik Adnan LKC, and I'll tell you what, that just turned into a melee. Gagne totally lost it.
Wild, I mean.
Gary DeRuscia asking Gagne if he pulled the tights. You know, wasn't that long ago when a referee would never ask Greg Gagne, did you pull the hair, did you pull the tights, did you close your fist? But what we saw with Adnan LKC, I mean, I'm not suggesting we saw a new Greg Gagne. We saw an infuriated Greg Gagne.
A wild Greg Gagne.
And a Greg Gagne who's a little lighter in the wallet, I suspect.
Yes.
Mike George. 265 pounds out of St. Joseph, Missouri. And as we've said so many times in the past, if you think you're a tough guy, if you think you can be a professional wrestler, you get in and you try Mike George on for size just one time.
He's a solid man in the ring night after night after night, and he's a big man.
Oh, yeah.
With it, so he can perform anytime.
Greg Gagne putting the pressure on the left arm of Mike George. You can see Gagne just really, really clamping down on the wrist area. Got his legs extended, his feet up against the underarm area and the side of the head of Mike George. He's got him all the way stretched out, but George is trying to put pressure on Gagne. Gagne takes him back over. And that, again, is the experience of the veteran, Mike George. Gagne, certainly with a controlling situation. And George trying to put it into a pinning combination to his own advantage.
You bet.
And here we go again.
Only experience teaches you things like that, because you've got to be relaxed and know where you are in the ring and be comfortable in what you're doing, and experience is the only place to get it.
You bet. Now, Gagne's been around long enough to know. Ooh, scrub of the boot across his face. Gagne's been around long enough to know that you can't win when you're lying on your back.
That's right.
That could have been a thumb in the eye. Gary DeRusher questioning Mike George. But Gagne certainly distressed. He took something in the eye. He's trying to clear his vision. I don't think he knows where he is right now. I don't think Greg can see. Reverse chin lock. And Mike George does it with authority.
He's a powerful man. Look at the size of that chest.
Oh, yeah.
Shoulders.
DeRusher checking for the choke. He said, no, it's clean. It's clean. Referee asking Gagne, you want to give it up? I'll ring it. I'll ring it. Even though Greg Gagne's title is not on the line tonight, I guarantee you one thing. Greg Gagne will not give up. I mean, you've got to carry him out of here unconscious. He won't give it up. And I've seen him carried out unconscious.
I think one of the strong points of Greg is the mental aspect of the sport.
Yep.
And the fact that he's a thinking wrestler, and he's always got the right move at the right time. And he can always come up with that one special move that'll get him out of predicaments and cover himself with it. And that's skill and brains and
right
thinking all the time, and thinking on your feet and being able to do it quick and react to it.
We're 5 minutes gone into this match already. Again, as a lot of you amateur wrestlers know, for every hold, there's a counter hold. Greg Gagne knows them. But so far, Mike George has not given Greg a real good opportunity. The truth of the matter is, George has been all over him like a cheap shoot. Gagne answers back. George throws that big forearm. Gagne throws the forearm. And we're back to square one. George with a thundering right hand. He's got Gagne draped over the top rope. Ooh, clubbing forearm to the side of Greg Gagne's face, and Mike George is back up and back on Gagne.
Gagne's hurt.
Oh, no doubt about it, Joe. Into the ring goes Gagne. Clothesline, and down goes Gagne. He caught him, Joe. One, two, kick out by Greg. Mike George questioning the cadence of the count by Gary DeRusha. Blocked by Gagne, right hand by Greg. Reverse knife edge by Gagne. And Gagne, he's fighting back for everything he's worth. Back up on his feet, throwing right hands and chops at Mike George. Into the ropes goes George. Ah, oh, Gagne went for the backdrop and telegraphed it. George went for the right hand and missed. Gagne fires back with a right hand of his own, and George is down. Knee lift by Gagne. And Mike George is down again. And Gagne is getting hot. Right hand by Gagne, and Mike George is reeling. Boom, into the turnbuckle goes Mike George. Back into the turnbuckle again. Backdrop by Gagne. And there's the Gagne sleeper, and he's got him in the middle of the ring, Joe. He can take it out right here.
In a match like this, the fans are really the winners, because they're seeing a tremendous...
Wait a minute. Here's Sheik at that LKC. Oh, no, the Sheik. Into the ring, he Pearl Harbored Greg Gagne. Gary DeRusha.
Lucia calling for the bell. Sheik Adnan LKC, Pearl Harboring Greg Gagne. Mike George, he's got Gagne up in the backbreaker. Oh, man. The Sheik laying that. Gary DeRuscia calling for Joe Blanchard. He's trying as best he can to get the Sheik and Mike George off of Gagne. DeRuscia's no match for these people. President Joe Blanchard just looking out. I guarantee
I'm not going to get in there and fight with him.
No. Don't you dare do it. Don't do it. Mike George throws Gary DeRuscia away. The crowd chanting USA. Sheik Adnan LKC. He's still got the bandage on his head from the damage inflicted by Greg Gagne not that long ago, Joe. Oh! That was absolutely uncalled for. I don't know if you saw that or not.
I saw it.
Sheik Adnan LKC taking that bullet belt, whatever you call it, and ramming it right into the head of referee Gary DeRuscia. And Gary is hurt. And there go those two goofs. And there's Greg Gagne. I'm sorry. I've just totally lost all respect for Sheik Adnan LKC. And Mike George going to work now on Greg Gagne. This all started with something as innocent as an interview. Vern Gagne being interviewed. And Sheik Adnan LKC coming from behind and attacking him. I'm sure that's what excited Greg in the first place.
That's what he said. Had to do with his dad, and I can understand it.
Well, Greg got his punishment. You find him. And now Sheik Adnan LKC. Here comes some other of the wrestlers. Trying to get Greg Gagne out of there. Somebody better pay a little attention to Gary DeRuscia as well. Greg's not getting up. Greg Gagne was awarded the match.
Yeah, I think that's rather obvious.
I think so, too, but I don't think Greg Gagne's got any idea where he is tonight. Here's Gary DeRuscia. Gary, the obvious question is...
I'm filing a formal complaint with Joe Blanchard right now. The Sheik is unstoppable. I don't know what's gotten into him.
Well, we're going to have to get some kind of a match to settle this feud, no matter what.
No way. Joe Blanchard, that man is uncontrolled.
Well, he can be... We've got some matches down in Texas that can control him, and we'll just see if we can get one out.
DeRuscia demanding that a formal complaint be written, and I'm sure Gary will take the time to write it and submit it to your office, Joe. As I said, Greg Gagne the winner, but I really don't think Greg Gagne cares. I don't think Greg Gagne know where he is. All right, let's have another look at this. And you take a good look at it, fans. And President Joe Blanchard, you take a real good look at it. There's Gagne. He's got Mike George in the middle of the ring in the sleeper hold. And there's Sheik Adnan LKC. Gagne's down. And there goes the Sheik. Stomping away on Greg Gagne. Now he says, Mike George, you take a whack at him. And, of course, Mike George isn't going to miss an invitation like that. He puts Greg Gagne into a backbreaker. Watch this. Bang. And that's what really hurt Gagne. Then that. It just gets worse from there, Joe. Yeah. I know you're going to review the situation.
Oh, we'll levy a fine or something.
The formal complaint being...
The important thing is that we need to get this thing settled with Greg Gagne and Adnan LKC, and we need it in the ring... with a special kind of match, and I haven't decided just exactly what kind of a match that can be yet, but they need to be controlled, and the man who can walk out then's the winner, and other than that, forget it.
All right. Larry Nelson, if you would you take it away, please?
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Lee Marshall sending it back to me in the locker room area. I don't know what to tell you. The doctors are still with Greg Gagne. I haven't been able to make any contact at all. Seriously and savagely beaten at the hands of Sheik Adnan LKC, who's entering the interview area, and Mike George.
I want you to take a good look to my forehead. That's what Greg Gagne had done to me about a couple of weeks ago. I can't even have it healed. Now... You think I have a surprise for you, Greg Gagne? what I have done to your father, Greg Gagne, put him in the hospital. I will put you back in the same bed of the hospital. I know I have a lot of friends, Mr. Lillian.
All right, I want to hear about this situation.
My
now,
friend here. How you doing? How you doing?
Are you hooked up with Adnan L. Casey, Mike George?
He has a lot of friends and he has a lot of money.
Yes.
He puts that money out. I'm there to take it. And Gagne, you're perfect.
Yes.
You know, it's fine what happened to your dad. Take a good look at him when he was in that hospital bed. That's where you'll be next.
Exactly.
And you might be out a little bit longer than him because you're messing with me. You understand? Mike George. And this man is my backer right here.
Yes.
He has the money. And when there's money,
Remember the belt?
The belt, the money.
Yes.
That's what it's all about.
You're telling me this is the big surprise you've been trying to concoct for weeks.
It's not the biggest surprise. It's one of them, Mr. Lennon. But you have to wait. You and the president of the AWA,
Mr. Jeff Lanchard,
you better be involved because me and my man, we're going to
sure we'll hear from President Joe Blanchard. Don't worry about that. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back.
Get set for the most incredible home video you'll ever see.
Sky Fury.
Feel the thunder of 3,000 horsepower Rolls-Royce racing engines. Diving, banking, rolling, racing inches above the ground. Sky Fury is precision that will keep you on the edge of your seat. You'll see spectacular crashes. Witness death-defying aerobatics as you ride inside the cockpit. Snowbirds, Thunderbirds, and rockin' Blue Angels, plus plenty of high-powered afterburner action, including the SR-71. This is no ordinary home video. Over 60 of the greatest aviation performers, 3 jet demonstration teams. Never have so many air shows been recorded on a single tape. Call right now and we'll give you handsome aviator sunglasses free with paid order. Dial 800-624-9800. 1-800-624-9800. 800-624-9800.
That was me, Tommy Lasorda, the way I used to look until I tried Ultra Slim Fast and I lost 30 pounds. With Ultra Slim Fast, I can eat and still lose weight.
Ultra Slim Fast. Give us a week. We'll take off the weight.